Class 8 Science Chapter 9 Reproduction in Animals, and in this video I will explain the answers of exercise questions of NCERT book. Come to the first question. Explain the importance of reproduction in organism. Okay, and its answer is, reproduction is essential for the continuation of a species, and it ensures the continuation of similar kinds of individuals generation after generation. This is the importance of reproduction. Second question. Describe the process of fertilization in human beings. There is sexual reproduction in human beings. Male reproductive organs produce sperms, that is male gametes. And female reproductive organs produce ova, that is female gametes. The sperms are ejected inside female bodies where they fuse with ovum and forms zygote. The single-celled zygote begins to develop into an embryo which attaches to the female uterus wall. The embryo further multiplies into many cells and develops further into a small baby called fetus. Okay, this is the process of fertilization in human beings. Next question. This is multiple choice question. Choose the most appropriate answer. Internal fertilization occurs. Now choice are in female body, outside female body, in male body, outside male body. Correct answer is in female body. A tadpole develops into an adult frog by the process of fertilization, metamorphosis, embedding and budding. Okay, correct answer is metamorphosis. The number of nuclei present in a zygote is none, one, two, or four. Answer is one. Okay, zygote is a single celled. Indicate whether the following statements are true or false. Oviparous animals give birth to young ones. False. Okay, the animals which give birth to young ones, these are known as viviparous. Each sperm is a single cell, true. External fertilization takes place in frogs, true. A new human individual develops from a cell called gametes, false. Egg laid after fertilization is made up of a single cell, true. Amoeba reproduces by budding, false. Fertilization is necessary even in asexual reproduction, false. Binary fusion is a method of asexual reproduction, true. A zygote is formed as a result of fertilization, true. An embryo is made up of a single cell, false. Now next question. Give two differences between a zygote and a fetus. See, zygote, make a two column and write the answer. Zygote, it is a single celled, that is it contains only one cell. Fetus, it is multi-celled, it contains many cells. Zygote, it is formed by the fusion of male gamete or sperm and female gamete or egg. While fetus, it is formed by the repeated division of the zygote. Zygote, no well-defined body parts are there in zygote. While in fetus, it has well-defined limbs and other body parts. Next question. Define asexual reproduction. Describe two methods of asexual reproduction in animals. Answer is, the mode of reproduction in which only a single parent is involved is called asexual reproduction. And they are the two examples of asexual reproduction. These are binary fission and budding. First come to the binary fission. Amoeba reproduces by this method. It starts with the division of its nucleus into two nuclei. This is followed by division of its body into two, each part receiving a nucleus. And finally, two amoebae are produced from one parent amoeba. You can also draw this diagram. Okay, this is a single-celled amoeba. First, nucleus is dividing, then this body is dividing, and finally, two daughter amoebas are produced. Another example of asexual reproduction is budding. In this mode, a part of the organism starts bulging out. Slowly, it grows and develops into a separate individual, for example, Hydra. These bulges are the developing new individuals and they are called buds. Again, draw this diagram. This is Hydra and this is a bulge. This is growing and finally this will convert into new Hydra. Next question. In which female reproductive organ does the embryo gets embedded? Answer is very simple. This is uterus. What is metamorphosis? Give examples. The transformation of the larva into an adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. For example, life cycle of silkworm. Egg convert into larva or caterpillar and that will convert into pupa and that is adult. Life cycle of frog. Egg convert into the tadpole and tadpole convert into adult. Now, differentiate between internal fertilization and external fertilization. See the difference? In case of internal fertilization, the fusion of male gamete, that is sperm, and female gamete, that is ova, occurs inside the body of a female partner, such as human beings, birds, and mammal. In case of external fertilization, the fusion of male gamete and female gamete takes place outside the body of a female partner, such as in frog, fish, and starfish. In case of internal fertilization, the female partner lays either fertilized egg or a fully grown young one. While in case of external fertilization, the female partner discharges unfertilized eggs. Okay. In case of internal fertilization, offsprings have a high chance of survival. यानी कि जिंदा रहने के चांस ज्यादा होते हैं. In case of external fertilization, offsprings have a low chance of survival. Now, this is complete the crossword puzzle using the hints given below. First, see across. Again, see in this answer. In the crossword puzzle, already some letters are given in the black color. Okay. And we have to write the complete spelling using these hints. The process of fusion of the gametes, that is first, across first. And this process is known as fertilization. This is fertilization. Okay. Then across the type of fertilization in hen. Which type of fertilization occur in hen? Six, you can say this internal, start from I. This is internal. Okay. Seventh, the term used for bulges observed on the sides of body of Hydra. I think you remembered. Seventh, starting from B, these are buds. Okay. And eggs are produced here and its letter will start, that is its spelling will start from O. And that is eggs are produced here. That part is known as ovary. Okay. Now come to down. Down second number. Now in case of second number, sperms are produced in these male reproductive organs. Okay. Second. And this start from T. And your answer will be testes. T-E-S-T-E-S. Then third. Another term for in vitro fertilization. See, third, this is, and this start from I, and this is IVF. Okay. Fourth point, these animals lay eggs. Fourth, that is, this will start from O. That's why this is oviparous. Okay. Oviparous. And at the fifth, a type of fusion in amoeba. And fifth number, you can say this one. This will start from B. That's why this is binary, B-I-N-A-R-Y. Okay. Thank you. Subscribe my channel to get the new videos from the next chapter.